Welcome to Pixotope Academy. In today's video, we'll discuss how to set up a virtual studio scene with an internal complane for your talent. Once you launch your virtual studio level in Editor, you'll navigate to the Pixotope Actors tab on the top left side. Here, you have the VS internal compositing plane. Grab this and drag it into your scene. An internal compositing plane is a plane which receives projected video from the tracked camera actor, and for all practical purposes, defines the bounds for your talent. Once you've placed the internal complane directly in front of the tracked camera, you can double check its measurements by going to Perspective, Top. We'll use the same rotational tools to move the plane directly in front of the tracked camera. Because we've already measured the distance from our studio camera to the talent, we can verify that with this top-down view. By holding down the mouse scrolling wheel, you'll be able to drag a measuring tool from the lens to the comp plane. You'll want this to mirror the same measurements that you have on set. Once we get this measured up and squared away so it's flush against the camera, we'll jump back into the scene. And now we'll make some fine-tuning adjustments, specifically looking at the feet. We want to make sure that we have the heels not hovering above the ground, and also have the toes not clipping into the floor. Alright, that looks good. Additionally, we can right-click the floor and convert it to be a VS floor, which sets the object to a state where the VS compositing plane will always be in front. This avoids the risk of clipping, in other words, we won't see the talent's feet breaking into the ground and intersecting with the floor object. Please be aware that this can be problematic from certain angles, so you'll want to test out any virtual camera moves in advance before going into production. Now that we have the internal comp plane relatively where we desire it, we're going to parent the comp plane to the tracked camera. We'll do this by right-clicking it and attaching it to the tracked camera. By doing this, we now can move the camera root around without having to constantly recalibrate the comp plane, and we'll be assured that we have the proper distance between the tracked camera and the talent, no matter where we adjust the camera's position to be. We can grab the camera root now and move it around, and as you can see, the comp plane is following as expected. Next, we'll clean up our comp plane and crop it to cut off any of the excessive area that's unnecessary surrounding our talent. Please note that if your talent is moving around, you'll need to know their full range of motion in order to not accidentally cut off part of their body or have them disappear as soon as they go past the edge of our comp plane. And for a final touch, we're just going to look at the shadows really quickly. Now, if we drag in a point light, you can see artificial shadows playing really well across the floor. And that's because we're projecting this from the inverse of the internal comp plane. All right, now we have a pretty good start to our virtual studio scene. Thank you for watching this tutorial, and please see our Help Center for more resources to get the most out of your next production with Pixotope.